Loko melayira izimzansi esikhundleni sikaNdunankulu eGoli uVuyiswa Ramakgopa wethule uhluko lwezimfuno zomphakathi kumasipala wesifunda iGoli egameni lezakhamuzi zaseLinaja South ngezithuba zasekuseni namuhla. URamakgopa ke uhlaba ikhwele lokuthi ke kulethwe izidingongqangi okungamanzi kanye nokuthuthwa kwendle kule ndawo akhala ngokuthi ke izakhamuzi sekuneminyaka emide zidonsa kanzima kukho. Ngaphezulu kwalokho uRamakgopa ufuna ke labo abathintekayo kulokhu kugqoza kweyidingo zomphakathi eLinaja South ukuba ke bethathelwe inyathelo.
Iqela lezopolitiko iRise Mzansi likhokhele umngcelele omalunga neenkonzo ezisemgangathweni zamanzi kunye nokutyulo kwindawo yaseLinaja South. Oku kuza nanjengoko eli qela lisithi abahlali baseLinaja South yiminyaka behlupheka bengenamanzi. Kwaye sele kulixesha bephakamisa lo mba kwisixeko nakumagosa achaphazelekayo. Kodwa akukho nto yenzekayo.
The community of Linaja South has been suffering without water for the last 5 years. And this is a function of a number of different things, and they've raised the matter many times with the city and with the relevant authorities, and it hasn't been resolved. At some point, they were promised that a dam would be constructed. 45 million rand was budgeted towards this dam, and still they go without water for more than 12 hours a day. So, Tina, as Rise Mzansi, we are saying that's completely unacceptable. Water is a basic human right. Every single South African, every resident is guaranteed the right to water as per our constitution.
IRise Mzansi ibuye yachaza ngeentlelo eziqingqileyo ukuqinisekisa ukuba uluntu luxhamla kugqithiso lwamanzi olusulungekileyo njengoko kulilungelo labo ukwenzeka njalo.
We have identified that the issue is actually around leadership and governance within the governance of water. So that's at a national level, at a local government level, as well as within the various water boards. We need to ensure that we appoint competent, capable leaders who are going to then be able to execute on their mandate of water provision. So that's our number one. Hire the right people to do the job. Number two, deal with the massive corruption. We've heard reports that there's water mafias that exist, people who benefit from the dysfunction of the system.
Eli qela lithi xa liqhubeka ukuqhagamshelana nesixeko lijonge ukuba kufunyanwe ngokukhawuleza izisombululo zethutyana ukuquka nezo zesigcina. Kwiindaba zeSoweto TV ndingunomzabalazo Mduka eLinaja South.
Sisaqhubeka nalokelo ludaba mbukeli. Iphini kamqondisi eminyangweni wokulethwa kwezidingo zomphakathi obviously le meya kamasipala iGoli uThapelo Mafa ulwemukele ke uhlulo lwezimfuno. Umafa ke womukele lolu hlulo lwezimfuno wabeke esethembisa ukuthi uzohlela umhlangano ngesonto elizayo ukuze ke kudingidwe ngezinkinga oluziqukethe ngenhloso yokuqhamuka neisombululo.
We received a letter that there will be organizations that are marching and demanding of service delivery, but the pressing issue was the issues of water cut that they are facing in the Linaja South. But I was here just to receive the memorandum and make sure that we address all issues that are being outlined in our memorandum. As you know, that the Mayor Kabelo Kwamanda always emphasize on issues of service delivery and servicing our people with good faith and good heart. So we are going to organize a meeting with the marchers probably next week, Tuesday or Wednesday, and we'll invite all entities that must respond or must provide services to these communities to outline the challenges that we have and also to provide a long-term solution. If long-term solution is going to be difficult, because you would know that Region G has a high demand of water and our reservoirs also need upgrade in terms of infrastructure.